Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Today we will see the ADOR experiment. Before proceeding, let me explain some of the details related to the experiments of 18CSL48. In 18CSL48, that is microcontroller and embedded system laboratory, you have total 16 experiments. You can see here, you have total 16 experiments. That is divided into part A and part B. Part A contains 8 experiments. All these 8 experiments are software experiments. We will implement by using simulation software like Keil Microvision 4. And part B is a interface experiment where we interface various device to LPC2148. So, in my earlier video, I have explained two software experiments like the experiment 1 and 2. In today's video, I will try to explain the hardware experiment, that is experiment number 16, display the XR digits 0 to F on 7 segment LED interface with appropriate delay in between. The pre-request for this one is GPIO configuration. GPIO configuration means general purpose input output configuration details of LPC2148. For more information, you can refer my earlier video on Vastech channel. So now let's proceed to the program. So here you can see the program for to display 7 segment that is to display 0 to F on 7 segment display. Before proceeding, let's have a look on 7 segment display. The 7 segment display contains 7 LEDs. Now we will see the 7 segment. 7 segment display looks like this. You can see here 7 LEDs A, B, C, D, E, F, G are connected in this fashion, and internal resistors are connected, and other than that we have one more, that is LED for a decimal point. And in our experiment we are using common anode type of LED. Common anode type of LED means anode is connected to interconnected and anode is connected to VCC. Now, in case of common anode LED, to glow the particular LED, you have to give 0 voltage at the input. Then the LED will glow. Now, to display 0, suppose I want to display 0, then I want to display 0. To display 0, that is, these segments should glow and this should be off. That is, G should be off. G should be off means 1. And our decimal point should be off means that is H is equal to 1. And rest of the segments should be 0 because it has to glow. So let me take you to the this worksheet. Here you can see various segments. To display 0, I have to make H is equal to 1, G is equal to 1 as explained. Rest of the segment is 0. That means you will get hexadecimal code as C0. To display 1 here, B and C should glow. To glow, B and C should be 0. Rest should be 1. Rest of the segment should be 1. So, to display 1, B and C LED should be 0 and rest should be 1. That means the XR value for this one is F9 to display 1. Similarly, you people can calculate what is the value to display 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. So now I will take you to kill version 4 to our program. This is our program. In our program, we have written the codes to display 0 to F. This is the first code to display 0. This is the second code to display 1. Like that, we have here different codes. All these codes are stored in an array of type unsigned int. So let me start from the beginning. The first line, the program is written by using embedded C. The first line will include header file that is related to LPC214X, which contains various library files. I have taken one integer variable I of type unsigned int. Then I have defined one delay function here. Then the main function, in the main function, I have defined the pins of port 0, all the pins of port 0 as an output pin, because I am going to connect this LED to the port 0 port on port 0 port on LPC 2148. LPC 2148, we have FRC4 connector. In our case, FRC4 connector, we are connecting this LED to that FRC4, which is internally connected to the port 0. That's why what I did is, here you can see, I have set the port 0 all pins as a output pin. Output pin means, I have set IO0DIR register as 1111. If you place 000 in the register, then it will act like input. But here I have set the direction as 1111. 1111 means output. That means all the pins I have set as output. In fact, all the pins are not required, but for simplicity, I have taken all the pins as a output pin. Now, while true, I have taken while true for I is equal to 0. This is the for loop inside the while loop. For I is equal to 0, to I is equal to, in my case, it is 16. I want to display 0 to F16. Increment I. And each time I will set the IO set register. I will pass the code from this array to activate the particular LED. Then I will call delay. Delay of around 1 microsecond. Then I will clear the register, whatever I have set, by using IO clear. That's all. Other than that, here you can see delay function. This delay function is used to generate the delay. Here we are using some counts. So that count is based on this formula. Here you can see peripheral frequency is 20 megahertz divided by 4, and for particular delay you have to calculate the count. The count is calculated based on the 5 megahertz and required time delay minus 1. Suppose the frequency is 5 megahertz and required time delay is 100 microsecond, then the count will come something like this. In this way, we have to calculate the value of count. Let's now start from the beginning. So I have opened kill version 4. The project is open now. Let me close the existing project. For that, I have to go to project and close the existing project. Since I have created the project, I will open the project directly. Instead of creating a new project, I will open the project directly. Open the project. So in open project, this is my project. So I'll open the project. So now you can see the project is opened and the particular file is also opened. It contains startup.s file also, because startup.s file is required because it has got some header files and built-in other files. So, and other than that, here you can see the code for 7-segment display. Once this is done, you have to compile it and build the exa file. So to before compiling, you have to do some certain settings. The settings is something like click on option for a target. Here you can see device, select the device LPC2148, then target. In target, enable use microlib. This is important. This is software related settings, and enable these options. If it is not enabled, output enable create exa file. Then in listing enable C pre-processor listing. This is required. And in user interface, nothing. C++ nothing. ASM nothing. Link enable this settings. These are the software related settings. Nothing to worry. Click on OK. Once this is done, compile the program. You should get zero errors. Yeah, zero errors are there. Fine. Then rebuild it. Then rebuild. So now you can see it has created the exa file. It will create the normal exa file by your project name. So whatever name you give to your project, by that name it will create the exa file. Now what we have to do is you have to transfer this exa file to our LPC21 microcontroller board by means of actually hardware debugger like JTAG. Instead of hardware debugger, in education institution and all, we will use a software that is called as a Flash Magic. So in Flash Magic, through Flash Magic, you have to transfer this image to the LPC2148 microcontroller. Before that, here let me debug this program. When you debug this program, you will see some of the important points. For that, let me start debug. This is the one way to start the debug. So I will start the debug here. Then let me check some of the port settings. For that, I will go to peripherals and I will click on this one, GPIO slow interface port 0. This one here you can see port 0 related settings for IO 0 directory register, IO 0 set register, and IO 0 clear registers. Let me click on now one by one, step by step execution. When you click on step by step execution, meanwhile you observe the changes in all these IO 0 DIR, IO 0 set, IO 0 clear, etc. So now, when it executes this code, this line of the code, all the ports of IO 0 are enabled. That means all the port, all the pins of port 0 are enabled. That becomes output port. Then second line like this, go to IO set. Now you can see IO set is also enabled. So now it is going to transmit the code C0 to the port 0. So why we are using C0? C0 is the first number in the array to display 0. So that we have transmitted to the output port. Then if you click on next, then it will call delay. In delay we have 1000 counts. So you have to keep on click this button till you cover 1000 counts. After that, this IO clear pin will change. IO clear pin will enable here. So I will not do that one. I will stop here only, and we will see rest of the part in demonstration section. So keep watching the video. This video is followed by demonstration section. Hello student, this is Vasant Naik from Vostek channel. Today we will see how to interface 7-segment display to LPC 2148 ARM7 based
microcontroller. Here you can see we have LPC2148 ARM7 based microcontroller, and here you can see 10 pin connector which is connected to pin 0.0 to pin 0.10. That means we are going to use port 0 starting pin 0 to 10. Port 0, pin 0 to 10. So I have with me 7 segment display. In our experiment, we are using 7 segment display common anode. That means anode is connected to common point and it is connected to VCC. So first of all, let me write the program by using Kill software. So let me open first Kill software. So in the Kill software, if the project is closed, first you have to close the project. I will close the project and I will start the project. In my case, I have already created the project. Let me open that project first. So this is my project. So here you can see the program. Here we have written a small code. In the later class, I will explain you the complete details of this program. But here you can see I have taken 0 to F that I want to display on the 7 segment. And then these are the codes we are going to transmit to the controller to display 0 to F. And this is the program here. So once you write the program, then you have to compile this program. So you have to build the exe file. So first I will build the exe file here. I'll get a zero warning and zero error. Once this is over, I have here one breadboard, 7 segment display is connected, and in the 7 segment display, here, this is the decimal pointer. So this is pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if you hold like this, pin number 1, left hand side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and counterclockwise 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here you can see the connection. In this pin number 3 and pin number 8 is internally shorted, and you have to connect it to common. This is the common anode and point, and you have to connect this to VCC. So here you can see on the breadboard. You can see this is the point I have connected to VCC through 330 ohm resistor, and rest of the connections are done according to data sheet. That will be explained later. So it is connected to FRC cable because I cannot directly connect it to the pin here. So it is connected to FRC cable, and FRC cable is connected to connector 4. Connector 4 here. FRC cable is connected to connector 4. After this, you have to transfer this image to this controller. For that, I have to use Flash Magic. So I will use Flash Magic. In the Flash Magic, I will select the image file. So image file is, this is my image file. I will select it. I will select this image file, and I will make the proper settings, and I will click on start. File is transferred, and you can see the display here. It is displaying 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F. Like this, you can interface 7 segment display to ARM controller. This is a simple program. Simple program, you can use the LPC module, but for basic understanding of this program, it's better to follow this method. Thank you.